or the statements. For all those reasons, y'all, and in light of the other allegations of violations of probation, I would ask that the court release Mr. Paul on PR bail with the direction to continue to report to probation as required, and that to attend the proceeding on the 24th of this month.
I would mind having protective orders against this sort of things.
Your Honor, Mr. Paul certainly has concerns about the other individuals in the legal. I don't know that the court has jurisdiction to address that.
Can't really issue that kind of order without them in front of me or a separate filing to get that kind of a restraining order. So I'm not leaving that in the context of this
case. I'll explain the jurisdictional problem to Mr. Paul later.
Thank you. Anything further from the state? Paul, if you would stand. I have given this matter some thought. I've reviewed the video, and in my view, I think more will be said in probation violation about hearing about the circumstances of this, but I'm satisfied that setting cash bail in the amount of $500 is appropriate in this case, but I do have a number of conditions I'm going to review. In terms of pending a probation violation hearing in this case, I'm going to find that Michelle live at 173 Washington Street, apartment 9, in Keene, and shall notify the court immediately in advance of any change of residence. The court must approve of any change required, such change taking place. You shall not travel outside of New Hampshire. You shall execute a waiver of extradition approved by the court. You shall refrain from possessing a firearm, destructive device, ammunition, or deadly weapon. You shall refrain from use of alcohol and controlled drugs unless lawfully prescribed. You shall submit your random test to screen for consumption of alcohol or controlled drugs. Further, you shall impose a curfew. You're going to be restricted to your residence every day from 8 p.m. until 6 a.m. and you'll comply with all the terms of probation. Let me say, there's this. Just to be clear, there's a sense. sample positive UA, I will revoke bail and detain you pending a violation of probation hearing.
Just one thing.
Yes.
Can you add, if he is released, he reports immediately?
Yes.
Yes.
We're not oftentimes in the loop if they post bail and then we want to release out.
Thank you for the discussion.
Thank you.
And as I said, we'll have a probation violation hearing to go forward on July 24th. Actually, if I can just see council very briefly at the bench.